Hello friend, welcome back to my new lecture on event handling. And however, it is continuation of the previous lecture of AWT and event handling. So today I am discussing about capturing and handling checkbox event. So we have been different type of the listener classes which is helpful for event handling. Action listener basically, and this is for button. Item listener is for checkboxes and other component of the AWT. Mouse listener, mouse motion listener, these are for mouse event. Key listener for key event. Focus listener, adjustment listener, component listener, window listener, container listener, text listener. So lots of these listener we have discussed and studied in the previous classes. So today I am discussing about this checkbox event. So basically, for checkbox we require the class checkbox class, and this is the object. Rockbox is the object of this checkbox predefined class equals to new checkbox, and rock is the caption of checkbox, and it comes under this checkbox comes under music group. So we require one checkbox group also. If we are not using checkbox group, then in that case we will select all the checkboxes, and while we are taking the checkbox group, then we will select only one checkbox from the group. So inside the main group, this is the checkbox group, music group, sorry, equals to new checkbox group. So all three checkboxes, rock, jazz and classical, these three checkboxes comes under music group checkbox. So this is checkbox group, and first one is true and other two are the false. So only we can select only one checkbox. Otherwise, if we are not using checkbox group, then in that case we will select all three checkboxes. We can select all three checkboxes. The first step in creating group of checkboxes in to create a checkbox group. So checkbox group we will create here, and but it is not mandatory. We can use checkboxes, and when we will direct you, then we can select all the checkboxes. But in case of checkbox group, we will select only one. The next step to create the checkboxes, supply the checkbox group object as second argument and checkbox to the checkbox constructor. So these are the three checkboxes. Now I am coming on a program of checkbox group. So you can see here in this program, we are starting the program by import statement, import java.awt.star, import java.awt.event, and import java.awt.applet.star, and then we have applet code. Applet code is CG group, because the class name is the CV group, and this will be compiled, and then it will be converted into dot class file. So we'll write here applet code, the class file, CV group dot class, or we can directly write CV group only. And its width is 250 and height is 200, and we'll close here the applet. So when we will execute applet here, then only this statement will execute, other statement will not execute. And in case of the Java, when we compile this code, then this line will be treated as a comment line, and other statement and will be compiled by JDK, because all other statements are the Java statement. So we have mentioned here class CB group, extend applet, implement item listener. So here we are using checkboxes. You can see here the checkbox and as well as checkbox group. So for checkbox we require item listener. So I have already given you the list of different listener. So this item listener, mouse listener related to mouse, item listener is related to the checkbox, action is related to the button, and key listener is related to the text box, text field, text area, as well as focus listener also we use for the text boxes. So we have adjustment listener is used for the scroll bar. So we have been different listeners. So item listener is used, basically this item listener will be used for the checkbox event. So in this program we are using the checkboxes, that's why we are implementing the class with the item listener. And this is applet program, so we have written here extend applet. And first of all, we have initialized the string with blank value, and we have three checkbox: window NT, window 98, Solaris and Mac. So we have been four with the name of four operating system. We have four object of checkbox, and we have one checkbox group and CVG checkbox group. For checkbox group, we have CVG object, and public void init is the first function. And inside this init function, we have defined the object of checkbox group. So first of all, we have defined the object of checkbox group. And we have four different object of checkbox: Windows 98, NT, Solaris, and Mac. Equal to new checkbox. So first one is the Windows 98, and its group is CVG, and it will be true. Only first one will be true, otherwise and other will be false. And user can manipulate it. User can when it will execute it, when it will display it on the screen, then user can deselect it and select Windows NT also. So second one is Windows NT 2000, CVG is the checkbox group and false. And third one is the Solaris, its caption is Solaris, CVG is the checkbox group and it is false. And Mac, for Mac OS, we have been again CVG checkbox group and it is false. Initially it is false. So we have mentioned four checkboxes, and now we'll add all these four checkboxes. Add 98, Windows 98, Windows NT, Solaris, add Mac. When we'll add all these checkboxes, they will be added on in the applet, because CB group is a applet. It is extending from applet, so it is applet. So by default they will be added on the applet. And now after this, it will only display, but it will not work. So we have to add event handling on these checkboxes. Then we will write here Windows 98 dot add item listener, Windows NT dot add item listener this, Solaris dot add item listener this, Mac dot add item listener this. So this means the same class is the item listener also. So we'll add the item listener with first checkbox, with second checkbox, with third checkbox, with fourth checkbox. All four checkboxes are added by the item listener. This event will be applied. Item listener is added with all four checkboxes. So the event item listener item event means checkbox event will be activated in all four checkboxes, and this is the object of same class, because the same class is implemented from the item listener. Now we have another function, item state change. So in case of the action listener, we have public void action perform, and in case of mouse event, so we have multiple function: mouse dragged, mouse moved, mouse clicked, mouse double clicked. So we have many functions, but in case of the item listener, we have only one function, item state change. Because in case of the checkbox, we change the state from true to false or false to true. So it will be it will have only one function. So public void item state change item event IE. So we'll have a repaint function. So as we will click on, suppose we have clicked on this Windows NT. So as we will click on Windows NT, this will activate item state change function, and here item event will generate, and it will start the repaint function, and repaint function will start the paint function, paint graphics G, and inside this function we have message. Inside the message we will store the value current selection, and in current selection we will store message equals to, we are using here assignment operator, so message equals to message plus CVG checkbox group dot get selected checkbox. So whatever the checkbox we have selected, suppose we have selected the Windows NT, so it will get the selected checkbox Windows NT and convert it into label, and this will be stored on the message. So it will display current selection is Windows NT. And by this third line G dot draw string, we will print it the value, print the message is current selection colon and then selected checkbox. So selected checkbox is Windows NT, its name is Windows NT, so it will display Windows NT. So this way we are running this program, and this is item listener program. So I think I have covered all the checkbox, all the listener classes in my this lecture as well as in the previous lecture, and we can use different component in AWT, and we can also use listener with these component. So this is the list box, so we will use item listener with list box also, combo box also. So you can see here the pop-up menu of this combo box, and this is again initially it will display like that, and when we will click on this arrow then it will be expanded and it will show all the element of this combo box. So how we'll add the component on combo box, so you can see. So for this combo box we will write choice. This is we require the choice class, choice country choice equals to new choice. So country choice dot add USA, country choice dot add Canada, country choice dot add Mexico. So you see USA, Canada and Mexico are the three fields, three values over this combo box. So we'll have these values. So the choice class, choice predefined class will be used for creating a combo box, and we have to add, simply we have to write the function add. By this function we'll add all the element in combo box, choice combo box. So this is the choice combo box. This is again this is list box. List is a rectangle containing the series of items. So we have been three items here, so we can select. Initially it will display like that. In case of list box it will display all the items, and when we will click on a particular item, suppose we have clicked this item, so it will be highlighted. So you can see here again this is the another type of the list box. Suppose we have more elements than the size of this list area, then automatically it will display the scroll bar. So if not all list items are visible, the scroll bar appear at the right of the list. So at this side, right side, it will display the scroll bar. So by using this scroll bar, we can scroll the list and we can find the selected items accordingly. So for creating the list box we require list class, list country list equals to new list, and in case of the combo box we require choice. So you can see here we have choice class, and here we require list class, list country list equals to new list. So list country list equals to new list 5. Suppose we have mentioned here 5 element we have to add in this list box. So then we'll write country list dot add USA, country list dot add Canada, country list dot add Mexico. So the function add is same in case of the choice as well as in case of the list. The same function will be used in both cases. So we'll add these elements here. So this is list box, and we will have also a scroll bar. So adjustment listener is required for this scroll bar, and we have a list of events. We have component event, focus event, key event, mouse event, adjustment event, window event, action event, item event, text event. We have different events which required for the event handling. So these are called AWT event, and we have used all these events, and we have different listener. Again I am showing this list of listener, change listener, container listener, document listener, focus listener, internal frame listener, item listener, key listener, property change listener, table model listener. So commonly used listener we have discussed in the this class and previous class, and however we have lots of listeners which can be used for different purposes. So you can see also in the previous class we have studied about the window event. So in case of the window event we have been different listeners, window closing list, in case of window listener we have different event like window closing, window closed, window open, window iconified, window de-iconified, window activated, window deactivated. Iconified means window minimize, and de-iconified means return to the normal size. And this is activated window, when we are activating the window, when we are deactivating the window. So window, we require window event as a argument, and in case of the key listener we require key event. In case of the item listener we require item event. So accordingly the pattern of the function and program is same in all the cases, and you can see here this is one of the program of the window listener where we are
using this in this program we are using button handler as well as frame handler. So we will have this class my app. We have one button OK, and we have frame my frame. So we are not using applet, we are using here frame. So we have mentioned here button object of button class and object of frame class, and inside this frame we will display this button. So we will have this public static void main, and inside the main we are running the constructor of the class. So my app is the name of class, so we are writing here new my app. So we are running its constructor, and through this constructor we are creating object directly. We are creating new my app dot go. So go is a function of this my app class. So inside we are writing mentioning here the object and object dot go function, and this is go function. So it will execute this go function, and here we have adding the frame as well as button. So in this my app class we are writing here frame is f is the object of the frame, f dot window listener. So frame on a frame we will apply window event, and on button we will apply action event. So therefore we are writing here f frame dot add window listener. So we'll add with frame window listener, and again we are writing new frame handler. We are writing here a new frame handler. So you can see here frame handler is this class. So you can see here frame handler, and this frame handler class is extended from the adapter frame window adapter, because this frame handler, this is the user defined class, and this is inherited from the window adapter. And inside this class we will have, this is somehow this is a different pattern of the program, so you can also understand this program also. So when we are using the window adapter, basically I have explained you the window listener program with help of window listener, but today in this program I am showing you the window adapter. So we will have to define one different class, and this class is inherited from the window adapter, and inside this class we have window closing function. We have multiple functions, so here we are using only one function, window closing. So we are using this function, and this function is inside this frame handler, and frame handler is extended from the window adapter, and the object of this frame handler, new frame handler, object of the frame handler will be argument of the add action listener. So frame dot add action listener, with the frame we are adding the window listener means with frame will apply the window event, but here we will use frame handler, and this frame handler is extended from the window adapter. Same way, the another statement you can see here, with button we are adding button dot add mouse listener. So we are applying mouse event on button. So we are writing here button, b is the object of button, b dot add mouse listener, and here we are writing new button handler. So we will have button handler class extend mouse adapter. So here we have public void mouse pressed event. So we are using only one event function here. So mouse pressed function we are using here. So as we will click on the button, so mouse pressed, because this is activated with the mouse listener, and here we have argument button handler. So inside the button handler we have mouse pressed event. So when we will click on the button, the mouse pressed event will generate. And when we will clicked on frame, so inside the with the frame we have window listener, and inside window listener we have frame handler, and here this frame handler we have window closing event. So as you will click on the frame, it will be closed, and it will be window closing event will generate, and whatever the message inside this window closing, it will be activated and displayed. So this is a type of program. This is a different kind pattern of the program. So finally I can say, this is the end of this event handling. So I have covered all event handling function, event handling listener, almost 90% the event handling function and listeners and adapters I have covered my previous lectures, and today I am completing all this event handling, and you can see the complete
knowledge of, you can find the complete knowledge of event handling with these lectures. And so thank you guys, thank you very much.